guys. So I know that many of us struggle with comparison in our lives, and it's really easy to kind of let that creep into our homeschooling plans as well. So today I thought I would share my own perspective on comparison. For starters, instead of kind of quieting the voice of comparison, I like to listen to it pretty loud and clear. To me, comparison isn't a thief of joy. It's more like a door to discovery, right? Like when I see that mom at the zoo that's totally keeping her cool and she's not at all frazzled by the whining kids begging for snacks, she's not stealing my joy. She's showing me an area that I want to grow in, honestly. And I think it's really easy to let ourselves run wild with this and to shame ourselves for not already being the parent we want to be 100% of the time. But in reality, we all have areas that we want to learn and grow in. And sometimes we don't even realize that they're there until we see somebody else that is just totally rocking it in that department. So I like to listen to the comparison a little. I like to notice it and ask myself if I'm seeing an area of parenting or teaching that I'd like to improve in. Now here's the thing. Sometimes it won't be, okay? Sometimes it's a simple case of personality or preference or lifestyle. So I have this friend Tina, for example. She's like the queen of spontaneity. She's fun and she's silly and she's always up for an adventure. And when I compare myself to her, I realize how different I am from that, right? Like I love to plan. I like knowing exactly what the day is going to bring. I want to know where we're going to be and when. And now both of these are positive qualities in parenting, right? One isn't better than the other. They just create different learning conditions. And they introduce this wide variety of experiences for the kids. So I don't necessarily want to improve in that area of planning, right? I'm totally comfortable with being like the Duchess of pre-planning, and Tina is totally comfortable staying the queen of spontaneity. But what I can do with that feeling of comparison is I can use it to like incite action and give my kids something that they might be missing out on otherwise. So I can call Tina and I can ask her for a trade-off, right? She can take my kids out for this spontaneous adventure, and I can have her kids over for this homebody afternoon of bread baking and read-alouds. And I think that's the beauty of comparison, right? When we see it for what it is, and only for what it is, we find that it's a study in contrast. It's just similarities and differences, and that's it. So my encouragement to you today is to notice those areas of life where you tend to compare yourselves to other people, whether it's homeschooling or otherwise, and ask yourself, is this an area that I really, truly want to improve in? If yes, then you already know what to do. If no, see if you can forge a give and take relationship with that person so that you're both utilizing your best skills for the good of the kids. I'll see you guys next time.